Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech. And today, Google has started to release its January 2022 security update and patch for Pixel devices. However, if you're on a Samsung device, such as an S21 Ultra, you may have already received it as early as 5 days ago. The rollout will continue over the next week in phases, depending on carrier and device, as it's up to your carrier and device manufacturer to push those updates. However, if you're on a Pixel device and you're not seeing it over the air, you'll just have to keep checking over the next couple of weeks, depending on which device it is. Now, I wasn't seeing it for the 5A, so I manually updated it using the Android website that allows you to do that. Unfortunately, to do that, you have to erase the device and then reinstall everything and restore from a backup. But you can push the update a little bit early doing that. Now, if you want to jump to what's new in the January update directly before I talk about a couple other things, you can see all of the time codes or chapters in the description below. Now, last month, with the December update, it brought over 100 bug fixes and updates, as well as new features with a Pixel feature drop, but it fixed a lot of issues on the Pixel 6 and 6 Pro. However, Google pulled the update and will include all of those changes and updates in the January patch together. The update is supported on the Pixel 3a up to the Pixel 6 and 6 Pro, but the unfortunate news is at the time of this video, Google has said that the January update will be rolling out to the Pixel 6 and 6 Pro later this month. Why they're not pushing the update directly to the Pixel 6 and 6 Pro, as it's their flagship devices, doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me, but apparently they have some issues where they need to delay it a little bit. I wish they'd push them to all devices at once instead of this staggered rollout, but there are millions of devices around the world, so I suppose that makes sense. Now, before I cover what's new in the January update, I wanted to cover one thing that was new in the December update that I missed. The December update includes a ton of different features, and if you have it on your Pixel 6 or 6 Pro, or 6 Pro specifically with the ultra wideband setup, where you can actually identify what's in the general vicinity using the ultra wideband antenna, there's a new toggle for that. So if we go into our settings, and then in our settings, we go to connected devices, scroll down to connection preferences. Under connection preferences at the bottom, you'll see ultra wideband or UWB. You can now toggle this on or off. So if you have the December update, you'll have this. If you don't, you'll have to wait until the January update where it's included altogether. Now, the first thing they've fixed has to do with the framework. They fixed an issue that could cause the screen to unlock after a missed call when no screen lock is set. So if you had a missed call come in, your screen could unlock even though you didn't want it to. They've also fixed some issues with your networking and general cellular connections for fixes and improvements, just general fixes, as well as a fix for an issue preventing emergency calls in certain conditions where there's some third-party apps installed. They haven't said what third-party apps, but as far as that goes, they've at least resolved whatever was causing that. Now, this pertains to all phones. So if it pertains to only a few phones, I'll mention that as well. Now, if you're using a Pixel stand, so you have wireless charging, such as the new Pixel stand for the Pixel 6 and 6 Pro, or the older one, they've fixed an issue that would prevent Pixel stand setup to start after updating apps in certain conditions. Since it's for the Pixel stand, it pertains to the Pixel 4, 4XL, 5, 6, and 6 Pro. Now, they've resolved an issue for the overall system, which was causing an incorrect data usage accounting in the network menu on some networks. So if you have a data saving plan set, so maybe data limit here, we'll go back, data limit. If you have that set, sometimes the data reported could be incorrect. That has been resolved. And that has to do with everything but the 3 and 3XL. They also fixed a number of things with the user interface in general. So the first thing has to do with a black frame that was appearing on your lock screen when you would dismiss the Google Assistant. So if you had that Google Assistant overlay here, sometimes when you dismissed it, there'd be some odd black frame around the whole thing. They've resolved that issue. They've also fixed an issue that caused certain memory leaks in the system UI under certain conditions. That pertains to everything but the Pixel 3 and 3XL. They also fixed an issue causing the navigation bar to be hidden when switching the device orientation in certain conditions. And I really wish they'd define the conditions a little bit better, as they could be a bit obscure, but this is for all devices as well, but the 3 and 3XL. And they've fixed an issue for picture-in-picture windows where they weren't rendering properly in certain apps. So that has been resolved as well. Now, something that seems to be specific to the Pixel 6 and 6 Pro that they've resolved has to do with Wi-Fi. That was one of the major issues with the update in December, as well as some others. They've fixed an issue causing the Wi-Fi networks to drop under certain conditions. So that has been resolved in this update. So those are all of the functional patches in this update, but there's quite a few security updates as well. I'll run through them quickly as far as what they pertain to, but if you want the details, you can see them on the Android security update page. And for the security updates, there's quite a few if we scroll through the security update page. And the first one has to do with Android runtime. There's one update for that. There's four framework updates, three kernel component updates, one kernel LTS update, one MediaTek framework update, five MediaTek components updates, eight specific to the Pixel security updates, eight Qualcomm component, one Qualcomm closed source component, 11 system and one Unisoc component update. So there's quite a few security updates, not as much as December's update, but there are quite a few. Now, as far as the overall device, after using it with the December update, battery has been pretty good. It seemingly lasts me through a day on the Pixel 6 and 6 Pro. Hopefully it's doing the same for you. I haven't had really many issues with that update, and I know some of the issues were with cellular on the December update, but with Google Fi or Project Fi, it's working just fine. I have no issues there. So thankfully I'm not experiencing that, but I know quite a few people are. However, it does seem I get less reception than some other phones, so maybe they'll fix that in the January update. As far as overall battery life, like I said, it gets me through the day. And if we go into battery, you'll see my usage for the past 24 hours. Well, there's a lot of TikTok and using other social media as well, but typically it gets me through a day without a problem. I'll put it on the Pixel stand at night without any issue. Performance wise, it seems about the same as before. I really haven't had any issues. I've been using the Pixel 6 and 6 or the Pixel 6 Pro specifically every single day as a secondary phone as well. And it's working great. So performance wise, it seems to be having no issues. It was a little stuttery when I was restoring the 5A after updating, but I typically expect that. The phones are nice and cool. They're not getting overly hot. And like I said, that would affect performance and overall battery life as well. So I'm quite happy with the performance and battery life. And I think this is a pretty good update. So if you're wondering if you should update, well, once it's available, I would definitely update. If you want to try it manually, you can, but I typically caution against that, as unless you know how to flash an Android phone manually yourself, I would typically stay away from that and wait for the over-the-air update. And hopefully that will be within days instead of weeks. Now, if you've stuck around until the end, I definitely appreciate that. And I wondered if you'd like to see more of these sort of Android updates, as I'm kind of known for covering all sorts of devices, but mostly Apple. However, the Android updates are something that I use myself, and wondered if you'd be interested in maybe One UI with S21 Ultra or whatever the S22 Ultra comes out, things like that. I'd love to hear from you about that in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.